नमो भक्ति विनोदायो सचिदानंद नामिने गौर शक्ति स्वरूपायो रूपानुग बरायते नमो भक्ति विनोदायो सचिदानंद नामिने गौरशक्ति स्वरूपायो रूपानुग बरायते नमो भक्ति विनोदायो सचिदानंद नामिने गौरशक्ति स्वरूपायो रूपानुग बरायते वांछाकल्पतरुभ्यश्च कृपासिन्धुभ्यैवस्तु पतितानं पावनेभ्यो वैष्णवेभ्यो नमः नमः वांछाकल्पतरुभ्यश्च कृपासिन्धुभ्यैवस्तु पतितानं पावनेभ्यो वैष्णवेभ्यो नमः नमः वांछाकल्पतरुभ्यश्च कृपासिन्धुभ्यैवस्तु पतितानं पावनेभ्यो वैष्णवेभ्यो नमः नमः नमो महावदान्याय कृष्ण प्रेम प्रदायते कृष्णाय कृष्ण चैतन्य नाम्ने गौर तुषे नमः पंचतत्वात्मकं कृष्णं भक्तरूप स्वरूपकं भक्तावतारं भक्ताख्यं नमामि भक्तशक्तिकं श्रीकृष्ण चैतन्य प्रभु नित्यानंद श्रीअद्वैत गदाधर श्रीवासादि गौरभक्तवृंद श्रीकृष्ण चैतन्य प्रभु नित्यानंद श्रीअद्वैत गदाधर श्रीवासादि गौरभक्तवृंद श्री कृष्ण चैतन्य विनदाय सचिदानंद नामिने गौर शक्ति स्वरूपाय रूपानुग बरायते भक्ति विनोद ठाकुर की जय। भक्ति विनोद ठाकुर की शुभ आविर्भाव तिथि की जय। ए दी होली अपीयरेंस डे ऑफ भक्ति विनोद ठाकुर, सच्चिदानंद भक्ति विनोद ठाकुर, ग्रेट वैष्णव इज नोन एज सेवंथ गोस्वामी, ग्रेट आचार्य ऑफ गौड़िया वैष्णव, लाइन ऑफ गौड़िया वैष्णव परंपरा. सो वी हैव टू ग्लोरीफाई भक्ति विनोद ठाकुर. So I have to speak in two languages, both in Oriya language and English language. So something I'll speak in Oriya, then English, then Oriya, then English. This way I may go on. So this is my request. All should sit patiently and hear katha attentively. One should not get up and go away if there is some language difficulty. Thereby, you will commit aparadh at the lotus feet of Bhaktivinoda Thakur. That means commit Vaishnava aparadh. So, to the end, all should sit silently, patiently, and hear katha. Thereby, you will get mercy from Bhakti Vinod Thakur. This is my request. So I'll speak something in Oriya, then English, Oriya, English. This will go. Bhakti Vinod Thakur Mahajan. Bhakti Vinod Thakur in Sajjan Toshani has mentioned what is the best type of humanitarian worker doing good to others, Parupaka. He has said there are three types of daya, mercy, showing mercy to this gross body. Is also one type of doing good. It is known as sat karma, punya karma. To feed the hungry is also. To make arrangements of medical treatment of patients, giving them some medicine, that's also showing mercy or doing good. One who is thirsty, to give him water, quench his thirst, is also doing good. And one who is suffering from biting cold, to give him some clothings, warm clothings, etc., is also doing good. And all this mercy are doing good pertain to this gross material body. Also, some are engaged in doing good to the mind. To impart education, or to open schools and colleges, making free education, that is doing good or showing mercy to the mind. But, topmost, process of doing good or showing mercy to the soul. Those who are engaged in preaching the science of Krishna consciousness, inculcating Krishna consciousness on others, and speaking about the science of the devotional service, they are doing the topmost humanitarian work, doing doing good to others, that is the topmost doing good. Thereby, one will free from these material sufferings and we develop complete Krishna consciousness and develop pure devotion, then we'll be free from material bondage and at last go back home, back to Godhead, and never come back here again to this material world to suffer. So who is doing the best type of doing good? Paropakar. Those Vaishnavas, those are engaged, those are dedicated their life preaching the science of Krishna consciousness, they are doing the best type of good. Understand? Those who are following the Karmakanda section of Vedas, the Karmakandi Vyaktis, they don't do such type of good. They are engaged, they may be engaged in doing some good to the body, gross body, or to the mind. But those are pure devotees. They are only engaged in preaching the science of Krishna consciousness, preaching the science of devotional service. They are doing the topmost good. This Bhaktivinoda Thakur says. What Bhaktivinoda Thakur said, how many understand it? And who is doing it? Only those who are Vaishnavas, Mahajanas, they know, they understand, and they are engaged in such activities. So how many are glorifying such Vaishnavas in this material world? Vaishnava kriya mudra vijnana bujhoy. Even a very vijnana, very wise, learned person, pandit, he cannot understand the activities of a Vaishnava. Persons who are engaged in doing some good to the body or mind, they are glorified very much in this material world or in the human society. But those who are engaged in doing good for the soul, how many are glorifying them, how many are recognizing them? How many know about the soul? How many see the soul? How many have developed that vision to see the soul? Very, very few. Therefore, those sadhu mahajanas, those who have dedicated their life, in the past those who had dedicated their life for Atma Kalyan, how many can understand and recognize them? If we get the mercy of the sadhu mahajanas, then we'll develop that vision, then we can understand them and see the soul and super soul. Therefore, such persons are very rare persons. In the material world, general people cannot understand them, cannot recognize them. So, they don't glorify such sadhu mahajanas, Vaishnavas. Bhaktivinoda Thakur, his previous name, karmi name, was Kedarnath Dutta. You understand? He was born in 1838 AD, September. 2nd September, in Nadia district, in the village, name is Ula. But it was his maternal uncle's house, not paternal. But his paternal uncle's house was in Odisha. So he belongs to Odisha. You understand? He belongs to Odisha. So the name of his father was Ananda Chandra Dutta. Name of his grandfather was Rajaballabha Dutta. The name of his mother was Jagan Mohini. You understand? Name of the father of Jagan Mohini is Ishwar Chandra Mustafi. So, the Ulagram, the Nadia Jila Ulagram, this maternal uncle's house, he was born there. But his paternal house was in Odisha. At that time it was district of Cuttack, now it is in district of Kendrapara, near the river Virupa. And name of the village is Choti Mangalpur. This is Bhaktivinoda Thakur Sripath. So last year this village, some of our devotees had gone. He had gone, I think, Jagadatma. And this day, that was 155th appearance day of Bhaktivinoda Thakur. And that village, one assembly, sabha, meeting was held. Dr. Fakir Mohan Das, this is one who was professor of this Itkol University, was a research scholar. He's writing a book recently, it was published on Bhaktivinoda Thakur. He's a research scholar. He's bringing out some, let's say, undiscovered facts about Bhaktivinoda Thakur. So on this day, last year, murti, Bhaktivinoda Thakur's murti, vigraha, was installed in law college of Kendrapada, because he was the first law graduate of Orissa, and he was a magistrate. So, the Kendrapada law college, they installed the murti of Bhaktivinoda Thakur, isn't it? He had gone there. And this year also, they were in that village, Choti Gram, they are also arranging a meeting as conference. Our Namahata devotees have already gone there. Do you understand? And today also, again in this law college of Kendrapada, there will be also one meeting. Do you understand? So our devotees are already gone. Vaishnava Krupa Atai Sarva Siddhi. If someone will get the mercy of such a Vaishnava, he will achieve all sorts of perfection. And I hope those who are now engaged doing this activity for the glorification of Srila Bhaktivinoda Thakur, they must get the mercy of Bhaktivinoda Thakur and they will achieve all perfection. I hope so. So I said in the Bhaktivinoda Thakur belongs to Orissa. So his paternal house was there in Choti Gram. When Bhaktivinoda Thakur was 2 years old, he was speaking in poems, poetry. when he was 6 years old, he read Ramayana and Mahabharata. At 9 years old, he read this Jyotish Shastra, astrology. When he was 10 years old, then inquired about Brahma, Brahma Jigyasa, inquired about the absolute truth. When he was 11 years, his father expired. When he was 12 years, he got himself married. And the age of his wife was 5 years. Do you understand? Age of his wife was 5 years. And and he was a very dear student of Ishwar Chandra Vidyasagar. Ishwar Chandra Vidyasagar was very famous in Orisha. He's a famous person. So Ishwar Chandra Vidyasagar is a student, dear student of Ishwar Chandra Vidyasagar. Ishwar Chandra Vidyasagar had written a book named Bodhodaya. There he had mentioned the Lord is impersonal. He had mentioned that thing. When Bhaktivinoda Thakur read that book, he asked his teacher, why don't you see the Lord? What is his swarup? What is his form? You have to first see him, then write. Why are you writing that Lord is impersonal, no form? Student asked the teacher. But Ishwar Chandra Vidyasagar was a very simple hearted person, and he admitted ignorance about Supreme Lord. His grandfather was Rajvallabha Datta. Bhaktivinoda Thakur's grandfather was Rajvallabha Datta. He was also a Mahatma. Therefore, he knows astrology also. One day he said, Bhaktivinoda Thakur, that at the age of 27, you'll get a very great government job, you understand? And I bless you that you will be a great Vaishnava. Then I'll speak in English. The soul said, pain is mightier than the soul. So Bhaktivinoda Thakur has used his pain. Mightier than the sword. Dharmasya glanir bhavati bharata. When there is, what to say, glani? Decline of religion, isn't it? At that time, Bhagavan Sri Krishna descends here with his associates, to re-establish dharma. And Bhaktivinoda Thakur is one of the associates of the Lord. So when such condition was there, dharma, Vaishnava dharma was declining, at that time Bhaktivinoda Thakur had appeared. Do you understand? During that time, there was decline of dharma, doubtfulness was there, some mundane logicians had come out, they are putting forth mundane logics. You understand, Sanatana dharma was declining. At that time, Bhaktivinoda Thakur appeared and he wrote many books. That means he used his pen, which is said to be mightier than the sword. Sandal said, pen is mightier than the sword. And he wrote very strong, in strong languages, many books. In this Vaishnava, Gaudiya Vaishnava Siddhanta. And he defeated all this bogus philosophy based on material science, materialism, atheism. He wrote books in different languages, English, Bengali, Sanskrit, different languages. Thereby, he inculcated this Krishna consciousness, real light, enlightenment. In order to give real enlightenment, transcendental enlightenment, he used his pen. Unless one hears from sadhana mahadhan who comes in the bona fide disciplic succession, one cannot develop Krishna consciousness. Teachings on Srimad Bhagavatam, what the Siddhantas there, in their books, Srimad Bhagavatam is known as Nigama Kalpataru Valita Phala, most ripened fruit, most ripened sweet and nectarian fruit of Vedic tree. They are real gurus. And Bhaktivinoda Thakur, in very nice poems, in poem form, all these Siddhantas, he expressed in nice poem forms. Those Siddhantas have been expressed by all Goswamis. Therefore, he is known as seventh Goswami. Following the footsteps of footprints of Jiva Goswami, Bhaktivinoda Thakur in 1884 established this Vishwa Vaishnava Sabha. You understand? Vishwa Vaishnava Sabha, re-established Vishwa Vaishnava Sabha. Thereby, he started the preaching of Vedic Dharma, Upanishad, Vedanta, Srimad Bhagavata, Sri Chaitanya, the teachings of Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu and his philosophy. And as his son, great Vaishnava, very powerful Vaishnava, Srila Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Goswami came, who who made more effort on preaching of this Vaishnava philosophy throughout the India, and also he trained his disciples and sent outside India to Western countries to preach this science also, Krishna consciousness. So when Bhaktivinoda Thakur appeared at that time, Lehman society was covered up with the dense darkness, ignorance. At that time, some atheists, many atheists were there. Those were saying that this Srimurti Seva is like the idol worship. Most of them were adopting Phalgu Vairagya, not Jukta Vairagya. Many also sampradayas were there, cropping up. Do you understand? So Bhaktivinoda Thakur wrote against these philosophies very strong words and established pure bhakti siddhanta. And I say in different languages, I wrote books in different languages, in English, Sanskrit, Bengali. These are famous books were there, Bhaktivinoda Thakur's books. Many books he had written. Sriman Mahaprabhu's Sikhya, teachings of Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, Chaitanya Sikhya Amrita, Jaiva Dharma, Datta Kaustubha, Srimad Amnaya Sutra, Tattva Viveka, Gauranga, Smarana Mangala, Sunyamadasagam, Harinam Chintamani, Bhagavatarkamarichimala, Swanagati, Gitavali, Kalyana Kalapataru, Bhajana Rahasya, Gita Rasikaranjan Tika, Chaitanya Charitamrita Amrita Prabhabhasya, Sikhyastaka Bhasya, Chaitanya Upanishad Bhasya, Upadeshamrita Bhasya, Life and Precepts of Sri Chaitanya, the Bhagavata, itadi. Many books he had written. Sri Krishna Sanghita also has written in Sanskrit, you understand, many books. Thereby, through those books, very in strong words, he established pure bhakti siddhanta and defeated all bogus siddhantas. And his books are appreciated both by learned scholars, sadhakas, even the conditioned souls also. He had given so much food for the soul. Especially his books like Sanagati, Gitavali, Kalyana Kalpataru, all these nice poems are very, very appreciated and such very good and palatable food for the soul had given us. And it's all is appreciated both the learned persons, pandits also, and also illiterate persons also. All appreciated by both. This is the such wonderful mercy, unlimited mercy of Srila Bhaktivinoda Thakur. Who can fathom his mercy? The conditioned souls, they are in bewilderment. They are in the whirlpool of Maya. Every step, they are bewildered. And this material world is a platform of examination. Do you understand? Place of examination. And Lord is putting you in examination test in every step here through Maya. Yes. Do you understand? How can one come out successful from this test? Those who are very eager to come out, to become successful, come out successful of this test, he must hear Mahajana Bani, what Mahajana have said. And Bhaktivinoda Thakur is great Mahajan. He had transcendental vision. Do you understand? And his words, if you will hear his Bani, his message to the mankind, very strong message he had given, all your, mistakes, bewilderment will forever be gone. Do you understand? What he has said, I will एक लेटर
भक्तिविनोद ठाकुर
चूज द टीचरशिप प्रोफेशन टीचरशिप प्रोफेशन बिकॉज इट इज नाइस प्रोफेशन देर इज नो करप्शन दो मेनी करप्शंस आर नाउ एंटरिंग इन टू इट आई से दिस छोटी ग्राम इन उड़ीसा his paternal house, he stayed there. At that time he saw those are jamindars, landlords, how they are, persecuting the innocent, villagers, illiterate. Education was not spread so much at that time in Orissa. Therefore, he came to Kendrapada. There he established the high school and became teacher there. In 1859, he came to Purushottam Khetra, from Kendrapada to Purushottam Khetra, and he entered. He sat for that examination of teacher's training examination and he passed teacher's training examination. Then he became a trained teacher. Then he got a job in high school in Cuttack, known as Collegiate School, Cuttack. He was teacher there. Gradually, he was teacher in many high schools, in Bhadrak also, the Bhadrak High School. He was teacher, he was headmaster of Bhadrak High School. And then in Medinipur also, he was teacher in High School of Medinipur. In many high schools, he was teacher. When he was in Bhadrak, headmaster of Bhadrak High School, at that time, his eldest son, Ananda Prasad, whose spiritual name was Achyutananda, was born. At that time he wrote a book in English, The Mathas of Orissa. English book he wrote and he gave all informations of many mathas in Orissa. Then he came to the administrative department. In 1866 he became deputy magistrate, deputy collector and deputy registrar of ex officio, and he got this mastership in the Chhapra Jila headquarters. While he was staying in Chhapra, he read Srimad Bhagavatam under a tree, and a Brahma Rakshasa was there in tree. When he was reading Bhagavatam and giving pravachan Bhagavatam, so that tree was uprooted, the Brahma Rakshasa was released. This is the glory of Srimad Bhagavatam. Seeing this, the people developed faith in Srimad Bhagavatam. When he was in Dinajpur, he got Chaitanya Charitamrita and Srimad Bhagavatam from Calcutta. Again and again he read these two books and understood the Vaishnava philosophy. He has written in his biography, autobiography, that from this time I developed faith in Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. I developed faith towards Vaishnava Dharma. That seed was there in my heart. But when I got all these books, then I got favorable atmosphere and environment for the germination of that seed. Day and night, I started reading the books on Krishna, Krishna Tattva. That was my hobby. In 1868, he came to Puri. He was transferred to Puri, came to Puri. That now you will see the Chaitanya Matha made by Madhav Maharaj. And that was, front side was still there. Bhaktivinoda Thakur was staying that thing there in Grand Road. That which is now Vaishnava Matha, that was, he was staying there. Bhaktivinoda Thakur. And front portion is, they are not broken, I think. It is there. Back portion broken and there is temple now. You are staying there. It was Mandala's body, name was Mandal body. He rented it and stayed there. At that time, there was English rule in India. At that time, the commissioner was Rebhansa Sahib in Orissa. English rule, Rebhansa Sahib was commissioner, and this Rebhansa Sahib was liking very much Bhaktivinoda Thakur. Though Bhaktivinoda Thakur was eternal Parshad, Nitya Siddha, Parshad, still for Loksikya, he accepted Guru. He accepted Guru Bipin Bihari Goswami, who comes and initiated in Pancharatrika process, and this Bipin Bihari Goswami comes in the succession in the line of Jahnava Mata, Jahnava Sakha. Do you understand? His first wife expired when Thakur Mahasaya was in Midnapur. Do you understand? First wife Jagan Mohini. He married in 12 years old. Jagan Mohini was 5 years old. He expired. Then he accepted a second wife, whose name was Bhagavati Devi. Do you understand? The name was Bhagavati Devi. And the Jananda Prasad was the son of the first wife. All other children from Bhagavati Devi. Bhaktivinoda Thakur has 8 sons and 5 daughters. So many. 8 sons and 5 daughters. Jananda Prasad, spiritual name is Asitananda, the son of his first wife. All others are children of second wife. The sons were Radhika Prasad, Kamala Prasad, Bimala Prasad, is Bhakti Siddhanta Prasarsati. Varada Prasad, Viraja Prasad, Lalita Prasad, now is Lalita Thakur, is still there. Disappeared, I think disappeared. And Sauraja Prasad, the 8 sons. And 5 daughters, Sodamini, Kadambini, Krishna Minodini, Syam Sarojini, Hari Premadini. 5 daughters, 13 children. So, his previous name was Kedarnath Dutta. In 1862, he wrote a book named Chaitanya Gita, a prose book. In that book, he mentioned his name as Sachidananda Pramalankar. Understand? After that, he was known as Sachidananda Das. In 400, Chaitanabda, Gaudiya Goswami Sangha, gave him this title, Bhakti Vinod. From that day, he was known as Sri Sachidananda Bhakti Vinod Thakur. Understood? Kedarnath Dutta, known as Sachidananda Bhakti Vinod Thakur. I said, first you had accepted teachership, then from teachership you went to administrative department, you became magistrate. In 871, in Atibodhi Sampradaya, Apa Sampradaya, there are 13 Apa Sampradayas, one of them is Atibodhi Sampradaya. And especially they were here in Orissa. One yogi was there, known as Bisaksena. He was saying that he was Mahavishnu Bhagavan, yogi, and also showing many yoga siddhis, yogic perfections. So one, in this Chaitra Purnima, full moon day of Chaitra, he proclaimed, he advertised that today I'll do Ras Leela and invited all young maidens, come, take part in Ras Leela. So all many maidens ran. And so there was complaint. People complained. They lost complaint. People, government, that's Revansha Sahib was commissioner at that time. English rule was there. And Revansha Sahib knows very well this Bhaktivinoda Thakur was magistrate at that time. So Revansha Sahib, he should order to Bhaktivinoda Thakur, you please go and see what is this. And Bhaktivinoda Thakur, he knows Vaishnava philosophy is Vaishnava. He immediately understood this is a Pasandi who claims himself Bhagavan. He's a Pasandi and says the Murti, Vigraha, Sri Vigraha, they are idols. Why are you worshipping idols? Made up of wood and stone. It's a great Pasandi. Bhaktivinoda Thakur then ordered, put him in jail. Then he should be imprisoned, lifelong imprisonment. Do you understand? Yes, lifelong imprisonment. So the policeman went there to arrest him, but it's a yogi, he knows. This yoga siddhis, miracles mismarries him. As soon as the policeman entered into his compound, their head reeled and they all fell down. Couldn't arrest him. Came back and said, no, we couldn't arrest him, he's Bhagavan. What you say? Bhagavan is a great Pasandi. We couldn't arrest him. The Bhaktivinoda Thakur said, come with me. The Bhaktivinoda Thakur himself went there chanting, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Ram, Ram Ram, Hare Hare. Chant Hare Krishna, the yogi's miracle won't act. Cannot do anything. Do you understand? That time they arrested him, then he was put into jail, lifelong imprisonment. So the day he was arrested and put in jail, at the time, also that yogi did that, he played his yoga siddhi miracle. The Bhaktivinoda Thakur has so many children, you see, 13 children, all small, small children, 1 year, 2 year difference only, small children. And so he was staying in Puri, and this person, yogi, was just staying here in this Khandagiri. He was doing that thing in Khandagiri. Do you understand this place here, Khandagiri? Do you understand? So that night, all his children were affected with diarrhea. Passing, loose stool, vomiting, blah, blah, blah. Then his wife, Bhagavati Devi, said, all my children will die. Oh, he's Bhagavan, release him, release him. Why did you put him in jail? Release him. You silly woman, he's a great person. Why are you afraid? You chant Hare Krishna. Then whole night they chanted Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, 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 Hare Hare, Hare Ram, Hare Ram, Ram Ram. So in the morning, all were cured. So, this is incident. So, you ask, all of that to discover the birthplace of Mahaprabhu. Do you understand? So, Bhaktivinoda Thakur at that time was staying the other side of Ganges. This side is Mayapur, the birthplace of Mahaprabhu. Other side was saying that is known as Swananda Sukhada Kunja. It's still there. So, when he was magistrate doing his government work during daytime, then coming back and at 5 you see, after this government work, then generally he goes to bed very early, taking food, then gets up at 2 in the morning he gets up. Then that time he writes his book, all books. That was his daily activity, daily habit. So he was very eager how to know which is the place where Mahaprabhu had appeared, what is the birthplace of Mahaprabhu. It was completely lost at that time, do you understand? So he researched. So at night when he goes up to the roof of his house, he used to see a pillar of light, a pillar of light at that spot, the other side of Ganges when Mayapur was there, do you understand? The birthplace. He was daily, he was observing that. What is this? Do you understand? And that was the birthplace of Mahaprabhu. And he came to know, then he discovered it, and that spot, that place, that land was under Mahmudans. And he could understand this thing by the mercy of Sri Jagannath Das Babaji Maharaj. You understand? Jagannath Das Babaji Maharaj, by his mercy, and he saw all this pillar of light, all these things, then he could understand and discover this is the spot Mahaprabhu was appeared, this birthplace of Mahaprabhu. That land was under Mahmudans. Then he asked those Mahmudans, what are you doing in this plot of land? They said, we use it as cultivated land, but we are cultivating it, sowing the seed, only Tulsi is growing, nothing is growing here, only full of Tulsi tree, plants. It is useless land. All right, give me this useless land. We cannot use it, only Tulsi plants are growing, nothing else, the Mahmudan said. We are disgusted with it. All right, then you give me this plot of land. Then he got that plot of land from them. Then he started constructing the temple for Gauranga Mahaprabhu. At that time, he was going out and collecting donations. Then stand door to door, he was going and collecting donations. At that time, 1 rupee is very valuable, 1 rupee. People were giving 1 paise, 2 paise, 5 paise, 10 paise, 25 paise. Do you understand? 50 paise one gives, oh, so much he gave, 50 paise. If someone gives 1 rupee, oh, so much. Because the value of 1 rupee is very great. Nowadays, even 500 rupees will not be equal to 1 rupee. Such You understand? Yes. One who was earning 1 rupee per month is enough for his maintaining livelihood. Yes. If he purchases the rice for 1 rupee, he cannot carry a cart is required. Cart load, such rice, 1 rupee rice. Today he purchases one rupee rice is some pocket. Such devaluation is there. So 1 rupee means so much. So he was collecting donations, 1 paise, 2 paise, 5 paise, 10 paise, 25 paise, 50 paise, 1 rupee, great. In this way, collected donations and built that temple at that time, Bhaktivinoda Thakur. Do you understand? In 1894, 21st March, the full moon day of Phalguna, Phalguni Purnima, Mahaprabhu's appearance day, he established Gauro, Sivigraha of Gauro and Vishnu Priya in that temple. Do you understand? And the same, the Purnima day, full moon day, Phalguna Purnima, Mahaprabhu appeared as there was lunar eclipse. Do you understand? Similarly, that day was also lunar eclipse. Same. All the auspicious yogas were there at that time, that same day. Established. So 1914, June 3rd, he appeared, disappeared. He entered into Nitya Leela. Do you follow? Towards the end of his life, the fine end of his life, he, throughout his life he was grihastha. Towards the fag end of his life, he took up Paramahansa Vesa, Baba Jivesa. Do you understand? He became accepted Baba Jivesa, became Paramahansa Babaji. But throughout his life he was grihastha. Do you understand? So, he had not taken up Tridanda Sannyas. Not taken up Tridanda Sannyas. Tridanda Sannyas, Bhaktivinoda Thakur started Tridanda Sannyas from, you understand, in Gaudiya Vaishnava line. Bhaktivinoda Thakur started from Bhaktivinoda Thakur, Tridanda Sannyas, otherwise, there is no Tridanda Sannyas. Goswamis means all Babajis. This is Babaji Vesa. So Bhaktivinoda Thakur also accepted Babaji Vesa. And this was the end of his, fag end of his life. And he disappeared on June 23rd, that is 1914, June 23rd. You understand? All right. Then I'll speak in Oriya. So, I was saying, Bhaktivinoda Thakur Nitya Siddha Parsada is eternal associate of the Lord. He had transcendental vision. Therefore, he had pointed out the delusions, bewilderment of conditioned souls, jivas. Through his mass bani, his writings, if you see, I will quote some of his banis, understand, quotations. Bhaktivinoda Thakur has written, those who are developed attachment to this material world, material objects of sense enjoyment, they are running after material enjoyment, material happiness. So their desire is unlimited desire, there is no limit to it. Their desire how to become Indra or Brahma or Shiva, they want. Do you understand? Thereby, material desire means only to suffer, no happiness. suffering and suffering. Jiva, such a conditioned soul thinks, if I'll be in possession of a skyscraper, multi-storied building, very beautiful wife, so much material opulence, many children, if I become king, great kingdom to rule, if I can discover and invent some new things in material world, then I'll be happy. And this is the purpose of my life. They think so. But Bhaktivinoda Thakur says, this is the great bewilderment. The atheist, material scientist, the devoid of bhakti, the logicians, material logicians, they try to make this dukkhalaya as sukhalaya. Bhagavad Gita says, material world is dukkhalaya, miserable platform, only dukkha, misery, sufferings are there, no sukha, no happiness are there. But this material scientist and the atheist, material, logicians, they are making effort how to convert this dukkhalaya into sukhalaya, miserable platform as pleasurable platform, or enjoyable platform. And they are also saying, yes, we are making resources. We will also, one day we will find out such thing that there will be no death at all. You will be deathless. Yes, we are trying, yes, scientists say. So they are just imagining, speculating all this. Bhaktivinoda Thakur says, what great delusion they have. Bhaktivinoda Thakur says, those who are devoid of Krishna consciousness, forgetful of Krishna, they are attached to this material world, temporary material world. But those who have realized their own swarup, they know, this is temporary, this is dukkhalaya, this is platform of misery, miserable platform. They know that what is this? This is temporary residence here we have. We are just staying in a motel. Staying in a motel. One night or two nights, nothing else. Our dham, our goal is Purushottam Kshetra. Lord's abode. So we are travelers. We are heading towards Purushottam Kshetra, going. So when there is dark night, such pilgrims, they spend night into a motel. Yes, in the motel. They spend night in a motel and wait for, they are awaiting, they wait for the sun to come out. And the sun, a false sun will come out, the darkness of night will disappear, then we'll catch up our path, our road, and go towards Purushottam Kshetra. So during their stay in the motel, they are just thinking when the effulgent sun will come out. They never sleep there and snore there. They never develop any attachment to the motel because it's only short stay. Why shall we develop attachment to such a motel? One who develops attachment to such a motel is a great fool. Bhaktivinoda Thakur says, there's a foolishness going on. Why are you developing such attachment to this motel, this material world like a motel? Is a wise, intelligent, does he develop an attachment to motel? The fools. One who is the motel owner, that is his business. Why? Your head expert, motel. You are not motel owner. Motel owner is the supreme lord. If you would have thought of to make it pleasurable, he would have done so. But it is not his desire, he doesn't want it. It is a desire that this motel will be miserable platform, dukkharaya. So you fools, why are you trying to make it pleasurable and enjoyable? Cannot do it. You cannot do it. You understand? If the owner of motel, that is Lord, would have thought of make it pleasurable, he would have done so. But it is not his desire. Desire this is, it will be, this motel will be dukkharaya. A miserable platform. Bhaktivinoda Thakura has written, however, whatever development you may make here, material development, this material world will never be free from this defects. You cannot get pure happiness from it. This is Siddhanta. Panchabhuta, five gross material elements, is all material, is all illusory. Nature is deficit. There is deficit. Deficit is its nature. So this material world will never be free from deficit at any time. No pure happiness will be available from it. Don't aspire for it. Those who are materialists, gross materialists, atheists, they are trying to make this miserable platform pleasurable and enjoyable. Murkhas, fools. They don't know what a great wrong they are going to commit, they are committing. Do you understand? The more we try to make this material platform pleasurable and enjoyable, the more tighter will be our material bondage. Bhaktivinoda Thakur writes, we should not expect any happiness or pure happiness from this material world. It is always dukkhalaya, a miserable platform, misery and unhappiness are there. Jiver swarupa hoy Krishna nitya das. The swarupa of jiva, eternal servant of Krishna. But those who want to be independent, do you understand? No, we should not be under Krishna. We are Lord. We should be independent. Those who want to be independent, those who give up the path of bhakti, how can we expect any good, any auspiciousness? Krishna, the jiva swarup is Krishna das. If you give up this thing, Krishna dasatva servitorship to Krishna, definitely you'll be servant of Satan, servant of Maya. Definitely. Yes, you'll be forced to become servant of Maya, servant of Satan, Maya. And you all become servant of Maya, Satan. Therefore you have been suffering here. You cannot understand your foolishness. These are all messages, bani, words of Bhaktivinoda Thakur, very strong. So many, has given many messages to this material world, the human community, human society here. This so pure message, so good, all auspicious, based on pure Siddhanta. Because those who are sadhus, mahajanas, their heart bleeds seeing this offering of But the jivas here, what is real happiness, they know, they understand, and they have told us. Bhaktivinoda Thakur has told us. And now the time has come to spread these messages of Bhaktivinoda Thakur throughout the world. Those who are leaders, they should understand it and they should take up it seriously. If they want to do real good to the human society, they should understand the message of Bhaktivinoda Thakur, practice it in their lives and preach it. Thereby, the whole society, human society, will get happiness. And so much mercy is there in these words of Bhaktivinoda Thakur. I have no strength. I have no strength to describe the unlimited glory of Bhaktivinoda Thakur. Only I am praying on this day, this holy appearance day of Bhaktivinoda Thakur. I am offering prayer at his lotus feet and praying for his mercy unto me, unto us, saying, Adadana Srunam Danti Ridum Jace Punah Punah Bhakti Vinoda Padabja Renu Syat Janma Janmani. Life after life, late Bhaktivinoda Thakur, great Mahajana Acharya, allow me to get some dust from his lotus feet. This prayer, I remain, I have no strength to describe his unlimited glory, multi-pointed glory. Yes, I have no strength. At last I said this thing and remain and pray for the dust from his lotus feet. Adarana Srunandanti Ridum Jace Punah Punah Bhakti Vinoda Padabja Renusya Janma Janmani. Sajidananda Bhakti Vinoda Thakur Ki
Jai!
Sajidananda Bhakti Vinoda Thakur Ki Subhavri Bhava Tithi Ki
Jai!
Samaveda Bhakta Vrinda Ki
Jai!
Gaur Premananda Ki
Jai!